Welcome to The Line. As we navigate the strange seas of COVID-19, many experts say we're likely to have more periods of stay-at-home orders as the disease flares up. New Mexico's aggressive stance has flattened the curve in some parts of our state. And while Governor Michelle Lujan Grisham has enjoyed broad support for her actions, people are getting antsy, no doubt about that. That's where we'll start this week. Joining us live by wire, a reporter for the New Mexico Political Report, Andy Lyman, is back to share his thoughts. Attorney in line regulars Laura Sanchez is back, and owner and founder of Vox Optima Public Relations, Merritt Allen. We're pleased to have her back with us as well. Merritt, let me start with you, starting with grants. Mayor Martin Hicks was all in on Monday when he chose to open up the city's golf course in defiance of the governor's orders to stay at home. The rest of grants, not so much. Two gun stores, a pawn shop, and a strip mall reopen. I'm curious your thoughts on this. Does this indicate that the protesting out there, while it might be loud, it might be smaller than we actually might think of it in actual a nose count, so to speak? What's your sense of that?
I actually think it shows that we can trust individuals and business owners to show the correct discernment on whether it's appropriate or not. Mm-hmm. I think that's the main thing. Siebel is kind of, as a county, is in the middle of the state with regard to number of cases. They're not the lowest, they're not the highest. But when I think about places like Grant County, like Lee County, that have maybe a dozen cases, their extraction industries have just been shuttered because of global demand sinking. It worries me. The mayor is certainly driven. He's in a populist mode right now. He's got some folks behind him. I think he's overreacting. I think the state is overreacting. But I think it points out, if we allow things to happen on a county by county basis, people are intelligent enough to take the right precautions and do the right thing for their business.
Mm-hmm. Andy, interestingly, we got word on Monday that the mayor and Grants had fired the city manager who runs the golf course there for not opening the golf course. Her pushback was, her employees were telling her not to open it. They were worried about, getting COVID-19. What's been the upshot of that? Any further on that?
She just recently filed, the city manager recently filed a lawsuit against the mayor, claiming under the Whistleblower Protection Act. So we'll see how that goes. And then, of course, the AG's office got involved. So I think it's a lot of probably court hearings or orders or I don't know what next, but yeah.
Mm-hmm. Laura, when I'm thinking about outside of grants, but just sticking with them for a quick second, when you have the governor against you, the chief of state police against you, the pretty much 62% of New Mexicans who agree that we should be staying home, how far can he honestly, or any mayor of any municipality, honestly take this? Or at some point, do the people kind of take it in their own hands as business owners and just either open or don't open on their own? It really doesn't matter what the mayor says.
Well, I think to a certain extent, we're seeing that. I think that the businesses, as Merritt said, some of them are using their discretion. And we see that even in other states like Dallas. I think in Texas, where there's been a somewhat of a relaxation on establishments, there's still some business owners that are refusing to open at full capacity or even at some lesser capacity. So I do think that business owners will take the risk into consideration because I think they do put their employees as well as the public at risk if they just defy orders altogether. But with regard to the mayor, in addition to all the parties that you mentioned, also the attorney general, and Andy mentioned this, has filed a petition with the Supreme Court, probably a writ of mandamus. I haven't actually seen it, but it basically asks for him to, do as he's supposed to do. And that includes following the stay-at-home orders. We have to remember, this is a state of emergency. We're still in a crisis situation. And, when you see what other states are dealing with, hard-hit places like New York City and their devastation, I mean, we are definitely seeing a lot less here. But even the New York Times recently had a profile of New Mexico and some of the early action that we took. And, I was one of those people even that I thought it was, at the time it was happening, it seemed so early compared to what was happening in other states. Mm-hmm. It seemed an overreaction. But now looking, hindsight is 2020, but now looking back, it really was an appropriate action to take because it prevented us from getting hard hit. And even the Washington State poll, or there was a University of Washington, I can't remember which institution, did a study and modeled that New Mexico would have many, many more cases than we have now. And I think that's really due in part to, it's due to the early action that we took, that the governor took, and then everybody took it very seriously. And I think that's prevented us from being so hard hit. I just think it's very irresponsible for the mayor of Grants to take it upon himself to decide when to open, especially when we're seeing such high numbers in McKinley County and Navajo. It's really too close to Grants, and it's something he should be taking much more seriously.
That's right. Navajo leaders have expressed their dislike at it since everything's just so cheek to jowl that way, like you're mentioning. Merritt, interestingly, in the polling, 62% of New Mexicans favor the governor's approach as opposed to 44% who do not favor. And that's according to public policy polling. And, you know, fairly tracks where national polls have been, not so much about the governor, but national polling, people seem like they're ready to sort of hang in there. Do you know what I mean? And they're willing to wait it out. What's your sense of it in the polling numbers you see locally for the governor?
Well, I think everyone in New Mexico has figured this out and figured out what's right for us. I'm probably overly careful since I have an 86-year-old living with me. So I'm a mask, glove, hand sanitizer, wipe down my card shop once a week, do things remote. That's my life, and I'm going to do that for the foreseeable future. Probably not everybody needs to do that. One thing I kind of appreciate is the moderate tone the state Republicans have taken in their opposition. They're simply asking the governor to consider case-by-case bases based on what's happening in the county and the number of cases, but also saying only do what's safe. That's very different, I think, from the extremists, and the mayor of Grants, of course, is one of those, who is also not a Republican. I would like to make that absolutely clear. He is a Democrat.
Mm-hmm. It's not a partisan issue, remember? So I'm saying that. It's not a partisan issue.
No, but some have tried to make it one. Some have definitely tried to make it one, and it's kind of it's a divisive issue, and it follows the lines of the tribalism that centers around our president right now, which is unhelpful. That said, I feel like everyone in New Mexico kind of gets it. There are a few extremists on both sides. There always will be, mm-hmm. But I'm eager to let folks decide what restrictions they want to take for themselves. My biggest concern is our election. Mm-hmm. I said that in the one more thing, but not delaying our election is a real mistake, because we're diluting our democracy by keeping it in, what, 4 weeks.
We're going to have to leave that there. Let me tell you this. While Bernalillo County, San Juan, and McKinley counties have been hit hard by COVID-19, it's something of a different story in Portales and even Las Cruces. And NMPBS producer Matt Grubbs spoke to people running two hospitals there about what's behind them and what's yet to come.